Hello everyone, this is Hoda Ganji and today I'm going to show you how we can set up a wood structure in Revit. So let's open a new file. I'm going to select the metric template. This is the file that we want to recreate in Revit. As you see, it's a wood structure building. Let me show you another view. Okay, so this is the building. We're going to start by setting up the grids, adding columns, beams and joists and shear walls. Then we're going to add the envelope and we're going to continue to create all the details. So as you see here, it seems that the building was originally designed using imperial system. It's in feet and inches, but at the same time, the main units are in millimeters. So in the Revit file, I'm going to set the units to millimeters, okay? But I'm going to show you how we can work with two sets of units. So we can start by setting grids. You can go to the architecture or the structure tab, go into the grid or type GR. I'm going to start the first grid. I'm going to draw it going from bottom to top. So the bubble shows at the top. But even if you do it the other way, it's okay. You can also show the bubble at the bottom. So as you see, it goes from 01 to 08, and each of them are 25 feet apart. Okay, so I'm gonna change the name of the first one to 01. So the next one would be 02, 03, and so on. I'm gonna type grid again, GR. I'm gonna offset the grids by 25 feet. Or 7620 millimeters. It's easier if I just put 25 and the feet. Okay. It goes all the way to 0878. There we go. Now I can move this out of the way. I want to show the bubbles on both sides for all the grids. Okay. On the other side, we have grids A through D. We're going to start with A. Type GR again. I want to draw the first one going from right to left so the bubble shows at left. But again, you can show the bubble on two sides. I'll rename this as A, so the next one would be B, C, D. So on the first one is 30 feet apart, so I'm gonna type GR again. I'm gonna offset the first one by 30, type the feet sign, okay. 9144, automatically it will give you 9144. The second one is here, 28 feet. I can change this to 28. You don't need to escape or something. You can just go on 8534. And here we have 8534. I'm going to round this up to 0.8534. Okay. And the last one is again 30 feet. So I'll type 30 again, 30 feet. So notice, although the whole unit system is in metric, I can type feet and inches over there and Revit will understand and it will convert it to millimeters automatically. There we go. I also want to show the bubbles on two sides for horizontal grids. Seems all good. I want to set up some dimension lines here. So I'm going to go to annotate, aligned, get the dimension here. Okay, I might actually move this a little bit higher. Okay, and it's a little bit lower. Okay, now if I click on the dimension line and go to edit type, I will be able to add a second set of units just below the millimeters. So I'm gonna go to edit type. I'm gonna go to alternate units. below, and I want to change it to feet and inches, and it will go to the nearest inches. Okay, and okay, it's 25 feet. That seems about right. Also on the other side, I want to use, let me move this a little bit further so we have more room over there and over here, and I can move this away. Seems good. Aligned that one. Okay, so it's 28 feet and 30 feet again. All looks good. So grids are first, levels are next. So let's go to a different view here. This view gives us a good dimensions on the levels. It goes from L1 to L2, L3 and the roof, 14 feet, 13 and 13. Okay, so that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go to one of the elevation views. Make sure you check the crop region. You can make it bigger. You can move the levels out. Actually, I need to move this up, and then I need to move the grids up. I want to change the first one to L1, and I want to rename the corresponding views. The second one would be L2. Yes. And let's see, we have 14 feet here. If I put 14 feet, it will know automatically that we mean 4267 millimeters. I'm gonna offset this level. You can go to architecture level or just type LL. I wanna offset that by 13 feet for a 3-end roof. So I'm gonna type 13 feet. It goes with 3962, and here we have 3962. I wanna round this up to zero because that's our precision. Okay, and one, two, L3 and L4. I wanna rename L4 as a roof. Yes, and we can check the dimensions here. 14, 13, 13, all good. I need to move this out. Maybe I would move this a little bit lower. And always make sure to check the levels in one of the east, west, and one of the north, south views. So here, I again need to move this up. I need to move this to the left. Can move this down. Oh, actually it should go all the way out. Okay, and I just want to also check the dimensions here. I want to make sure I have the dimensions in all the views. Okay, that seems good. That seems good, and it seems good here. Okay,